But we want to thank God for Jesus tonight. Ah, this is the day that the Lord had made. And I will rejoice. Yes, and be glad in it. Hallelujah. I don't care what your situation is today. Rejoice and be glad. But this is the day. Woo! You've been summoned here by the Spirit of the Lord. You're not just here just for Prophetess Bynum. You're not just here just because you just wanted to come, but you've been summoned by the Holy Ghost. It's a mandate of God that you be in L.A. for such a time as this. Woo! Hallelujah. I want to tell you that you're in the river of God in this place, and that you're in a divine overflow. Somebody did get that. You're in a divine overflow. Heaven is releasing something. I want you to know that the angels of the Lord is in here. I already know that they're already in here. I already know, as one was just sitting there, standing there beside me, the angels of the Lord are encamped in this place today. And I want to tell you that whatever your needs are, there's a woman in this place that has a tumor in her belly. Glory to God. And I want you to know that God is drying it up today. You are being healed right now. There is someone else in here that is having bleeding in your bowels. The Holy Ghost said the blood is stopping. Woo! Thank you, Lord. I don't know who that woman is that has a tumor in her belly, but if you're in here, come to me now. Rosh, y'all gonna stay down there. Get down there, down there, down there, down there. Get on the floor, get on the floor, get on the floor. Woo, glory, shout out of us. God, in Jesus' name. Woo, glory, get more shout out of us. Thank you, Lord. It's done in Jesus' name. It's done. Woo, thank you, Jesus. Glory, glory, glory. God says, now is your day of deliverance. Now, in Jesus' name. Woo! Go! Woo! In the name of Jesus, go! I release the fire of God on you today. In Jesus' name. Go! 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 Jesus. Woo! Come on and
Lift your hands up.
No. Lift them up and say, receive from the supernatural. Come on here. The super is coming into your natural. Come on, and receive from him. Glory. I keep hearing the Holy Ghost say there's a face injury. It's a nerve in the face. I don't know what that means, but somebody's face in the side of your face there is a, I don't know if you were injured or it's just that there is a, your nerves, there's like paralysis or pain or something that you're affected in your face, in the side, in your cheek area, in your bone area. I don't know who you are, but if you're in here, it's you, sister. Receive it right now, because God said he was moving. Come on and receive it right there. Come to me, you with the blonde hair. No, just receive it. Come on and receive it. Just receive it. Receive it in Jesus' name. These are the only ones that I'm gonna lay hands on that's right up here now. Don't nobody else come. My, the fire of God is all over you, sister. In Jesus' name. Ooh, lift your hands up, sister, and go and receive. Now, I'm not going to be able to lay hands on everybody, so I want you to lay hands on your own cheek. And I want you to receive it right now. Come on. Because this isn't because of me. It's him. Just come on. Now in Jesus' name. Come on. I receive my healing. It's almost like it's in the joint. Receive it in the name of Jesus. Receive it now. Be healed by the power of God. Be healed. Be healed. Be healed. Be healed. Be healed. Be healed. Receive it. Be healed. Be healed. Be healed. Thank you, Lord. Gotta stop. Come on, let me give you this word. Woo! Bless it. Somebody bless it. You're gonna bless your way out of a stroke. Bless it. Somebody been trapped in a stroke. Sit down. Hands lifted. God's getting ready to drop something in here. For all of you that are ready, he's ready to drop some wealth on y'all. I hear him saying wealth, 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 wealth. You better believe it. Come on. Believe it and receive it and give God praise for it, because God's loosening on you. Right now, receive it in the name of Jesus. I release kingdom giving, kingdom sowing, kingdom wealth. And he told me that there's 2,000 of you that he's commanded you and mandated you today to sow $50 in this service, in this anointing. And he said that as you do this, he is going to begin to loose money. He said you're going to be loosed. That $50 was going to be your, the money that you, what do you call it? Glory. Thank you, Holy Ghost. Say it. Glory. Debt cancellation. That's not the devil they want me to say. Debt cancellation. There's 2,000 of you in this place. And if you'll run up here now and put it on this altar, he told me that you will be writing an email in Prophetess Bynum's office. And you're going to let her know that God did just what Mother Nichols said he would do. That I am in debt cancellation. God is reading them. Oh, come on. Woo! See, you got to sow your way. You got to sow your way. It's 2,000 of you. The Holy Ghost said 2,000 of you. Bless it. right now. I don't know who you are, but if you desire a baby, I hear the Holy Ghost saying, a baby, a baby, a baby. If you desire a baby, put your hand on your womb. And in the name of Jesus, I declare and decree in Jesus' name, by this time next year. Oh, they didn't get that. Oh. By this time next year. Now, some of you women that have children, shout for them. Praise God for them. Pregnant in the spirit with a spiritual baby. Put your hand on your spiritual, on your belly. Come on here and bow down and pause. Come on, in Jesus' name, burn, burn, burn it out, burn it out, burn it out. Push, push, push. You already been through the process. the victory. Woo! Hallelujah. If you believe it, say it. If you believe it, say it. That I'm free today. I'm living in the victory. I'm living in the victory. I'm in the overflow of God. I'm in the overflow of God. I'm in the overflow of God. I'm in the river of God. Come on. The banks are overflowing. Woo! Woo, Jesus. Sit down just for a minute. I just gotta give you just this little word. Just this little word. Yeah, am I? Ooh, how much time? Arthritis from your neck down to your feet. Excruciating pain. Receive it now. God's doing it. Because whoever you are, receive it. The Holy Ghost said, pain from the neck down to your feet, just go and receive it. Declare it so. Come on. By faith, receive it now. Do something that you couldn't do before. Stretch, bow, run, bend, whatever you have to do. Hallelujah. Just for a minute. Let me just for a minute. Get your Bibles and turn to Psalms. Let me tell you who you are. And I believe you already know it because that's why you're here. As Prophetess Bynum said last night, she said something very pertinent that was very prophetic when she talked about kingdom. Although I'm not going to talk about, necessarily go into that about kingdom because it's very extensive, but I want you to know that you are kingdom people. How many of you believe that? That there is a difference but a similarity of the kingdom of God and the kingdom of heaven. Kingdom of heaven is a place and a territory. It is a place. It's a geographical place, a territory. But the kingdom of God is a function. It's a function. So God wanted me to give you this prelude before I share anything else, and I gotta go real quick because I only have about 20 minutes left. But the kingdom of God is a function. So what God is saying now is that he is requiring and he is loosening and has released the kingdom of God on the church in this final hour. So that means that your abilities has changed. What has to change now is your mindset. There has to become a paradigm now, a new mindset that I'm kingdom, and now my function is different. When I used to walk in mediocrity and walk in fear and doubt and self-centeredness and self-deception, but now I'm walking in the bigness of God. Somebody, you got to get this right here. Because if you realize who you are, see, many of us don't understand who we are. We have an identity problem. Because we have not yet identified who we are. We know that God is God and he's our Father, but we don't realize that. just here just to have church and go to heaven. There is a function. Say function. There's a kingdom function. God, kingdom of heaven, God is he is the king over it. Kingdom, kingdomain. So, the kingdom of God is over the kingdom of God, kingdomain. So, he has dominion. So, what does that tell us? That God has given us dominion. And power. Can I tell you that that's the next place that God is taking the church? That's where he wants to release, that's what he wants to release on us now is power. The world is looking for power. Oh, y'all ain't gonna help me. Wait a minute. That's just a prelude. Psalms. So now God is requiring us to operate in a different mindset. We gotta stop thinking small. We got to stop being fearful. We got to start thinking God-like. If God said I can do it, I can do it. And we got to take that scripture literally. I can do all things. Not one, not two, not some. All things. Through Christ who strengthens me. So we got to realize now that we can do all things. There is not one thing that should be a challenge to us now. It may approach you as a challenge, but a kingdom person with a kingdom mind, when a situation comes that looks bigger than you and it looks like you can't control it. Your mindset is yes. You may look bigger than what I can handle, but I can do all things. You're not too big for this God in me. Give God praise. 68th division of Psalms, the 11th verse and 12th verse. The Lord gives the word of power. There's a word, a new word. There's a word that God is placing in the mouth of the women in this hour. I'm going somewhere. Hold your seatbelts for a minute. The Lord gives the word of power, and the women who bear and punish and publish the news are a great host. Look at this. God is giving the women of God in this hour a word that has power in it. An empowered word to change territories. To change the economy. To change the government. To change the church. To change your household. I'm talking about kingdom women. The Lord gives the word. Look at your neighbor and say, God gives the word. And the word is empowered by God. God gives a word of power. And the women say women, 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 say women. Woo. Who bear. That's why I told you to bear down and push out. Because there's a word that God's putting in the mouth of women now. And he's impregnating you with a word for the nation. How many of you feel like you got a word that God has put inside of you that's for the nation? How many of you feel like you got a nationwide ministry? You got a nation in your neighborhood. It's the word of power. He says that. And the women who bear, not only bear it, but release it. Publish it. Release it. Release it. Speak it out. Manifest it. Walk it. Deliver it. Are a great host. Then he says, the kings of the enemies, the armies, they flee. They flee. She who tarries at home divides the spoil left behind. Can I tell you, and I want you to turn to a scripture right here that's going to back up this. Glory to God. Judges 4 and 1. And this is the story of Deborah. Do you know that there's a mantle? That there's a Deborah mantle? That God is raising up a new breed of women? That are going to walk under a new mantle? And the mantle that they're walking under is power, dominion, increase. Come on, come on, come on, come on. They'll be able to speak and see things change just by the word of power that's spoken out of your mouth. Watch things change the atmosphere. When you walk in a room, the atmosphere changes because you just walked in the room. You kingdom woman. You kingdom woman, you. You've been empowered with a word. This is the season of declaring and decreeing. That's what that means. To declare and decree a thing. And watch the thing change as you speak it. I declare and decree that you are healed. I declare that you healed, and I decree that that demon won't come back. And watch, I declare money cometh. I declare my health is restored. I decree and declare change. Somebody praise the Lord in here. It's time to release what's in your belly. Here Deborah is, a woman that's married, but has a kingdom mindset, a kingdom anointing on her life. Come on here. A woman that has the ability to judge. A woman with wisdom. A woman whose husband honors her. A woman who knows how to take care of home and the business. Home and the ministry. And do them both well. Here she is, a woman who judges a nation of people. Some of you, God will even send literally to the government, to the president of the United States. Some of y'all can't think that far ahead. You know, your mindset is, I'll never stand before the president. You don't know what God. You will stand before presidents of nations. And you'll go and you'll say, thus saith the Lord. And you'll speak prophetically. And you'll see that nation being changed because you spoke the word of the Lord, which was empowered by God. Give him praise. Now, you're not here because you're milk drinkers. Prophetess Bynum made that clear. All of you in here are supposed to be meat eaters. So what I'm saying to you is not too far-fetched that you're empowered to speak into situations and into your life and to the lives of others and watch change. We're in the hour of the manifestation. We're in the season of the manifestation. I mean, now. I'm not talking about 2 years from now. I'm talking about right now. All God wants you to do is just be deliberate and get in agreement with his word and believe what he says. And when you believe what the word of God says, when you say what God says, when you believe that you can do the same thing Jesus did. Oh, you don't believe that. He said, greater works. in us and those in those days, in the days of the apostles, that the Holy Spirit, I mean in the Old Testament scripture, that the Holy Spirit had not yet come to the earth. He would just come upon them at times when God needed work to be done, when God had an assignment. Come on. But now we have the throne of God on the inside of us. The King sitting in his domain. All power. Oh, Jesus. I can't get no help in here. All power. Look at that cancer and tell that cancer, all power. Is given unto me the same authority, kingly power. I got imperial power. I'm an emperor in the kingdom of God, and I got a right and power to speak to the situation and command. You line up. Devil, take your hands off of my children. Somebody better praise God in here. So Deborah is a woman who recognized her ability and walked in it. Say that. Walk. It's one thing to know that you gifted and you talented and you anointed and you got all that power sitting up in there and do nothing with it. But when you utilize, say utilize. The reason why we live in such a lack and deficiency and mediocrity is because we don't walk in what we know. Now, I know this may not be no great message to you, but let me tell you something. If you receive this word today, you're going to walk in a different kind of anointing when you leave this place. I hear the Holy Ghost say, you're going to walk in health. You're going to walk in wealth. Woo! Your household's going to come in order. Your children are going to line up. Your job going to line up. You shall have whatsoever you say. Say it. Say it. Say it. Say it. And watch it come to pass. If you say it, you will see it. Take that kingdom mouth with all that kingdom authority and say a word. If you say it, it'll manifest. I'm talking about what I'm walking in. I'm talking about what I'm walking in. Not what somebody told me, but I'm walking in it every day. I say what I believe because the kingdom is big in me. Therefore, sickness, disease, and none of that stuff can live in this body. It has to die. Come on here. Because I decree and declare and I say it, I speak it. I'm almost finished. So Deborah was a woman that was anointed to judge and to rule. Here is this man, Barak, who is a mighty leader of an army, Israel. He has this fear on him because there is a mighty warrior called Sisera. How many of you got some Siseras that just won't move? Every time you turn around, Sisera's in your face. So Barak is tired now. But he realizes, I need to go and fight against this man, this army, but I can't do it alone. So here he says to this woman. Look at your neighbor and say, God calling a woman. Oh, y'all didn't say that like a minute. Say, God's calling a woman. That doesn't leave the man out, but God is calling a woman. You've been empowered to lead. Uh-oh, I just said the wrong thing. So he says to Deborah, I need you to go with me. She says, I suppose she hem-hawed around a little bit. But then he says, if you don't go, I'm not going to be able to go. I will not go if you don't go. Listen, the man of God needs us to go with him, women. I did. I said a mouthful. Can I tell you that they need us? Not to rule and control, but they need us to go alongside of them. If God's going to do anything in this hour, he's not going to do it without teamwork. So all of you women that are afraid to come forth to the front line, Deborah was on the front line. She wrote on the front line with the man of God. She wasn't in the back. She was right in the chariot, on the front of the battle. Come on, at the front of the battle with the man of God. And let me tell you what he did. He delayed for a while. Oh, he procrastinated. He was a little fearful. She said to him, prophetically, prophetically, say prophetically. She heard a word and she spoke the word and she said, didn't God say, didn't God say that this is the time now that you should get up now and go and fight? So God is speaking to us now, women. This is a new season. And we're declaring in this hour, God is saying to the church, God is saying to the church and the territories, he's saying to the men of God now, and we're saying out of our mouth, it's time to get up and take the kingdom. We'll go with you. Let us go with you. Let us go with you. But if you don't let me go, I'm going anyhow. Bless the Lord. I'm almost finished. So here, they ride into the battle. She said, now, if I go with you, if I go with you, they're going to say, that a woman won, because she knew already that they were going to win. So she said, if I go with you, they're going to say that a woman won this battle. Barak said, I don't care what they say. And there's a breed of men that's coming forth now and saying, I don't care what other men think. I'm calling the women to come. Come and go with me, all of you Deborahs. I don't care what they say. I want you to ride with me. She rode with him. They won the battle. Listen, but Sisera, they defeated, killed everything in there, but Sisera slipped away. As hard as they fought, the main devil, the prince, slipped away. But, say but, there was a little housewife. Woo! There wasn't a judge or a ruler. Didn't have no prophetic calling on her. Didn't know what apostolic was. Come on. Never ran no revival. not on the front line, come on, but in her kitchen, mixing her pots. But while she's mixing, woo, she's stirring up something. She's stirring up something in the spirit. She's interceding and not knowing it. Come over here. Because God is sending the devil to her house. Don't you be afraid. He steps, he comes on her territory. Tell the devil, let him come. Come on, say it. Let him come. Tell him, I want you to come. You women of the kingdom. Say it. I want you to show up. Come on, devil. Come to my front door. I just want you to show your face. Just bring your behind up in here. A stirring spoon. Look at that girl, had nothing but a cup of milk. Woo, she seduced him. Don't you know, women, that God empowered you? That's why you gotta use your power. You gotta use it wisely. You gotta know when. She took a cup of milk. Said, he knocked on her door and she said, come on in. See, you got to know, you got to be wise as a serpent. When you're in warfare, you got to be wise. When you know you're dealing with an enemy, you got to be wise. Especially territorial demons. You can't touch everything that shows up in your face. Come on, you gotta know who. You gotta get an assignment from God. God told me that last night while I was laying in the bed. He said, tell them that they can't mess with every demon that come to their door. Only the ones God assigned you to. Come on here. Some of y'all getting killed, getting beat down, losing your mind. Because you're stepped out prematurely. So somebody got to cast the devil off of your mind because you're tapping and messing with demons that God hasn't ordained you to touch. Oh, they don't like me. They don't like me now. You ain't got to prove nothing to me. I don't have to know that you're anointed. I don't have to know that you can cast out devils, but there's some principalities and powers that you've got to inquire of God. Can I touch this? Hear me good. Hear this good. Because you're front line, you still got to have wisdom. Wisdom is the principal thing. You just don't run into everything that looks good. Just because you feel like you got the anointing to do it, may not be your anointing that's needed for it. Hear me good. Y'all hear this good. Hear me good. So I don't have to prove nothing to nobody. So I'm a general, so I don't have to prove nothing. I ain't got to lay out this floor and roll, see. All I got to do is tell you what God is saying. I don't walk that thing. I know what I'm talking about. I didn't just start yesterday. I've been in this thing for 50 years. I didn't just start. So, when he knocked on her door, she said, come in. God had her positioned. Say position. See, God will have you positioned for what he has called you to do. The mandate that God has on you, he'll position you for it. And he'll empower you for it. And he'll give you wisdom in it. And he'll give you the word of power for it. I want every woman in here to look at each other and say, don't touch everything. Don't touch everything. Say it again. Be careful. Don't touch everything because it looks like it can make you look good. So that everybody know I'm anointed and I'm prophetess so and so. The devil don't care nothing about your title. He wants your anointing. He wants your joy. A joyless Christian is a detriment to the kingdom of God. A Christian with no joy. The devil wants your joy. Because the joy of the Lord is love. So, come on in, she said. Lay down. Let me put you on my finest sofa with my silk that this with my husband slept on. And I'll give you access to lay down on my husband. She laid down. First she said, let me give you a glass of milk. He said, I'm thirsty. She had a glass of milk. Come on, say why. Housewife's weapon. Come on. The weapon of a housewife. A cup of milk and a knife. A steak. She didn't have to go hook up on a sign and calling down Gabriel and Michael. She just went in her kitchen where she spent her time. See, wherever you spend your time at, whoo, that's where God is. Come on, that's where God is, wherever you spend all of your time. Your Bethel, where you spend your time is your Bethel. It becomes the house of God, where the presence of the Lord is, where the ark of God is. Place where you're empowered. Jesus, oh, y'all don't like me. Gave him the milk, he drank it, got real warm milk. It's a sedative. Put that rascal to sleep. Then went in her kitchen and got a hammer and a steak. A stick. Got down there and put that steak, drove it in his head. The anointing of a housewife. Now it says in Psalm 68, and I'm about to sit down. It says in Psalm 68 that when the women that published the word, it's a host of them. They empowered with a word from God and they published it. But then it talks about the woman that's at home. That she stay home, take care of house, and get. So for you women that your children are still smaller, you can't go like I can. But you know you're limited in your ability to go. Mm-hmm. But that woman stayed home. The woman that stayed home gathered the spoil. JL gathered the spoil. Deborah pushed it. She operated under the mantle of Deborah. Y'all don't hear me. She operated on her mentor's mantle. She had a mentor's cloak on. She had a mentor's coat on. So therefore, she had wisdom. She knew how to judge between the concept of whether allowing him in her house. She had the shrewdness of Deborah. And she had the empowerment of her mentor. Y'all don't hear me. That's why you all are here. Because you got a mantle on me. Or you trying to get a mantle. this woman, Jael, operates in Deborah's mantle and delivers, because until Sisera was gone, the devil was still in operation. You got to kill the head honcho. And God used a housewife with the household tools, with the wisdom of her mentor, and defeated a whole army. And then out of that, Deborah birthed a soul. Out of that, Deborah birthed a soul. Can I tell you that when you defeat your enemy, when you walk in the wisdom of God, and when you walk under kingdom authority, God will release a new level of worship. That's where we are now. Stand up and lift your hands up. There's a new level of worship that God is releasing in this hour. It has nothing to do with hype. And I want the minstrel, and I'm getting ready to sit down, I want you to play something very majestic with an angelic sound. You see, for worship, organs is not the key. Organs, thank God for the organs, but that's not the flow in this hour. When we dancing and shouting and praising, that's fine. But for worship, thank you, Jesus. Yes. Everything, everybody in here, lift your hands. Every instrument that's available. The tabernacle of David is being released in this hour. You women that have and know that you have an assignment from God on your life. Obviously, you know that or you wouldn't be here. Because for some of you, it cost you to get here. Your airline ticket alone was expensive. Hotel expensive. To eat expensive. But it was worth it. But it's worth it for the impartations that you receive. I want you to lift your hands, because this is the time of the impartations. There is even another sound that has it's an angelic sound. I can't, when you hit it, I'll know it. It's like bells too. God wants to take us into another level of worship. See, we need to learn how to quiet down and tap in to the presence of God, where God rises up. That's it right there. That's it. Lift those hands straight up to God. And even if you're not used to this kind of flow, I want you to tap in. I want you to just tap into heaven. And because you're kingdom, and kingdom is on the inside of you, you shouldn't have any struggle tapping in to God's presence, to right into his face, right there, right there. And this is where miracles and signs and wonders take place, right here. And this is the place where, even if some don't believe, it does not make the truth of God none effect. God still is going to do what his word says. Close your eyes and lift those hands and begin to worship God. Jesus. This is where you can have anything you want right here. What you give God, he'll give back. Come on. Worship him. Come on, open your mouth and take it up there. Take it on up. Worship in the spirit. We worship you. Come on and worship him. Stop looking around and worship him. Take it higher. This is the place where cancer is healed. Bless you, Lord. Just go on and worship. There's a left breast being healed. A left breast. Oh, Jesus. Peace forevermore in your presence. Hey, every act of cease in your presence. Nothing but peace in your presence, Lord. There is for tomorrow. I'm delivering you. Joy. New joy. I'm releasing joy. Someone's cycle is being healed. There's a cycle problem. God is healing. It's really a serious problem. It's really serious. And God is healing you now. Yeah. I saw you in your blood. Woo. And I commanded you to live. worship the Lord, worship him, worship him. Oh, thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Oh, la 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 la. Now put your hands together and bless God in this place. Bless him in this place. Bless God in this place. Bless him in this place. Bless him in this place. It's an urgency that you bless him in this place. He's turning some stuff around. Bless him in this place. Oh, hallelujah. Oh, bless him. Bless him, bless him, bless him. Bless God in this place. Bless your name, Jesus. Praise it for your future. Praise it for your future.